Welcome back. In this video, we are going to see what is a package, how we can create a package of our own, how we can import a package, and what are the advantages of package. So let us start with the definition. What is a package? Normally, it says a package is a container for the classes. Normally, if you have classes which is similar types, we can put in a package. Why? Because we in Java we have no restriction like two or more classes can have the same name. Nobody is going to stop you where we are going to name more than one class with the same name. But obviously, when we have more than one class with same name, there'll be a collision, and we call it as a name collision. So to avoid this, what we do is we are going to put these classes in a different package. And normally, this is now stored in a hierarchical manner. Let me repeat, which is going to, or this is used to put together classes of same type in a package, and the package contains not only the classes, which also contains interfaces and sub packages. As we know, it's difficult to find a unique name for every class, and we cannot stop somebody to give the same class name which you have given for your class. We cannot stop somebody from doing it. So the solution is package, where we are going to put together the classes of similar type and which is going to act as a container for the classes. So let us see the different types of packages. Normally, this is divided into two categories. One is user defined, other one is built-in package. So let us see what is what. So under built-in packages, we have many packages starting from java.lang to java.net. As you know, java.lang is a package. So this will be this package will be included or imported automatically in every program. And this is going to give you the support for the classes. Like, you know, the primitive data types and mathematical operations all will be defined inside this java.lang package. So automatically this will get imported. And the second one is java.io, so which provides support for input output operations. Like other language, Java also has got its own input output operation. To support this, we have to use a package called java.io. The next one is java.util, so which provides or contains utility classes which implement data structures. You know what is a data structure? Like, you know, we have a linked list, queues, and other operation like date and time. So everything is defined, or which is going to give you utility classes to support all this kind of data structures. And the next one is Java applet. So applets are we know, these are a small Java program which is located in remote location, and we could download it on our system and we can use it. And this applets does not contain the main method. Normally every Java program contains a main function or main method, but applets does not have. So java.applet contain classes for creating applets, applet programs. These are tiny Java programs. Next one is java.awt, so which contains classes for implementing components for a graphical user interface, window based applications. And the last one is java.net. This also contains many classes which in turn supports networking operations. So these are the few built-in packages. So please do remember what is java.lang, java.io, java.util, java.applets, java.awt, and java.net. So next, let us see what is a user-defined package. So as we just discussed, package is going to avoid name collision. That means using package. Basically, package is like a directory or a folder where or with the help of this package, we can have more than one class with same name, provided you put them in a different package. So these user-defined packages are defined by the user. So what you do is you have to create a directory with your package name and create the classes inside that directory. So this is a way to create the packages. So let us see how we can do this. Before we see how we can do this, let us see what are the advantages of using packages. As we discussed, so this is now used to categorize the classes and interfaces so that they can be easily maintained. We are going to categorize that, and by which we can maintain this very easily, not only classes, even interfaces. And second use is which is going to provide protection, access protections. We know there are four access specifiers, like private, default, protected, and public. So what it is and how this is going to help us in protection, we are going to see in the coming videos. And for the timing, please do remember this packages is going to provide access protection. And the last one is very important, which is going to remove the name collision. Name collision, nothing but we have classes, more than one classes with same name. And if you put them, if you keep them in different packages, this is going to avoid the name collision. So this is about, these are the few advantages of packages. Now let us see how we can define a package. So for defining a package, so we have to include the command package at the beginning of your program. So you can see that package is a keyword, and you can keep your package name. And all the classes are declared within the file belong to the specified package. After this, whatever the classes, if you write, all the classes will belong to the package called mypack. So if you omit package statement, what happened? The class called simple is going to be, or which is going to put into a default package. That means which has no name. Now if you look at the given example, where you can find a package called mypack. So look at this package is a keyword. Mypack is nothing but your package name. And we have created a class called simple with the main method, and which is going to print a message called welcome to package. So this is same as any other Java program. Only difference is we have created a package of our own and we named it as mypack. And it's not it is not mandatory, like you can have only a single class. You can have any number of classes inside this package. If you look at this case, we have a single class called simple. So you can have any number of classes, but make sure that within a package, you cannot have more than one class with the same name. You can have more than one class with the same name. That should be in a different package. So this is about defining a package. So please do remember, you have to include a package command. Any classes declared within this package is going to be, or that is going to belong to the same package. The package statement defines a namespace in which classes are stored. So this is going to define the namespace where the classes are stored.